faith in the human physiology. I have learned that if I give these cells what they need, the way they were meant to be given, that the body will produce what it needs at the right time in the right dosage.
It's very exciting stuff. It's definitely the cutting edge of medicine and things that we don't hear about in medical school. So I think it's a necessary supplement to people who are interested in healthcare.
Excellent, excellent conference. Fabulous speakers, Dr. Amen. People at the cutting edge of this type of medical approach, what I would call alternative therapy. So it gives a well-rounded approach to what I'm familiar with. Being a pharmacist, I'm familiar with standard treatments, but we like to bring in the whole picture for our clients.
Well, this is my second year attending, and every year it's wonderful. I learn something new all the time. I'm a physician and an ex-pharmacist. Of course, they do an excellent job bringing new speakers and really get you to think outside the box, just like it's intended to do, and I'll be back next year.
I've had a lot of questions answered for me, and I wanted to meet Dr. Amen. I also wanted to learn more about bioidentical hormones and weight loss, and it seems like a functional medicine overall, and so far everything has been good.
Yeah, you can a superfood.
I really appreciated Dr. Amen. It was encouraging to see that we could change so much. Just showing that the body heals. The body heals, line up, do the right thing, and it heals. So I appreciated that. Seeing such brains and such despair could come so whole again.
See, the whole back half of the brain is dying. And that happens way early. Your brain's so smart. It has many redundancies built into it. You have to actually lose 30% of the hippocampus, the major memory structure in the brain, before you have your first symptom.
You can't catch type 2 diabetes. That's like walking into a dark room and you open the curtains and the room fills with light. Well, we know light is a physical particle. It's a photon that travels through time and space. Can you have darkness in the presence of light? No and no. No, you can't. So just like you can't have disease in the presence of a healthy body. So instead of treating the disease, why don't we teach people to get well?
This is how the human body works. If your physiology and your biochemistry is all working perfectly, then you're a healthy individual. So if there's a deviation anywhere in this chemistry, it causes a pathology. And physicians treat pathologies, but I found that they treat the symptoms of pathologies. They don't treat the deviations.
Well, I think we're very familiar with traditional therapies, how they react in clients and how our clients react to them. We have to be able to look at the whole picture, and I think our folks want an opportunity to understand medicine in a total all-around approach.
For me, it explains a lot of what I do, that I don't know why I do it, and it also makes me think about why I shouldn't be doing a lot of what I do and why I should be doing things differently.
And if you are in a remote place like I am, you don't have access to a lot of information, and so when you come to a conference, you can get to a network, you can get to learn firsthand from a lot of specialized people.
Medical students should hear the cutting edge of medicine.
If you stay in the box, your patients don't get well, you get frustrated, and then you complain about how medicine has changed. If you get out of the box and you make a significant difference in your patients' lives, you stay motivated and passionate about your work. So how does someone get out of the box? I mean, why do you escape the box? I mean, I can tell you, for me, I got tired of making people worse.
We are entering a very exciting era in health and healing. We're starting to understand the healing power within and how to balance the body by optimizing physiology and biochemistry. It is very exciting to be part of this era, and each and every one of you can contribute significantly to its future.